Hello students, welcome to NIRS Education Channel. Let us continue the lesson, The Thief Story. In our previous session, we came to know that Hari Singh, he stole money from Anil and he went to railway station, and at that time, the Lucknow Express train, it was just moving out and it was there in its pickup speed. So, if Hari Singh wished, he could have caught that train. But for a moment, he hesitated and he did not climb the train. In this way, he missed that opportunity to go away from that city. After that, just he was standing alone in the deserted platform and he did not want to go to any hotels also in order to stay that night, and the only person he knew in that place, in that city, was Anil, and he told about the expressions of the people, how they would react when they lost their money. Greedy person showed fear, the rich man showed anger, and poor man showed acceptance. But he thought about Anil. Anil would not be so sad. He would be little sad because, not because of losing the money, but for loss of trust. Now let us continue the lesson. I found myself in the Maidan and sat down on a bench. The night was chilly. It was early November and a light drizzle added to my discomfort. Soon it was raining quite heavily. My shirt and pajamas stuck to my skin and a cold wind blew the rain across my face. Yes, then he moved to a Maidan. Maidan means a playground. And he sat on the bench in that Maidan. The night was chilly. That was very chilly night. Chilly means very cold night. It was nearly November time and a light drizzle added to my discomfort. What do you mean by drizzle? Drizzle means to rain light. A light rain started to fall and it added to his discomfort. Already he was in worried mood and he became even more worried because of, he became very discomforted because of that rain, light rain. Soon it was raining quite heavily. Earlier it was light rain, the rain increased, it became heavy. My shirt and pajamas stuck to my skin. His shirt and pajama, they were closely attached to his skin, stuck to his skin. And a cold wind blew the rain across my face. Cold wind blew and raindrops, they started to come and hit to his face. I went back to the bazaar and sat down in the shelter of the clock tower. The clock showed midnight. I felt for the notes. They were damp from the rain. Then he went back to the bazaar and he sat down in the shelter of the clock tower. Clock tower means like this, one tower which contained big clock. The whole city people can see that clock and they can see the time. And downside that there was some shelter like place and he took shelter under that clock tower. The clock showed midnight. The time, it was a midnight time, nearly 12 o'clock. I felt for the notes. Then he touched the notes. They were damp from the rain. They became what? Damp. Damp means wet by the rain. Anil's money. In the morning, he would probably have given me 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. But now I had it all. I couldn't cook his meals, run to the bazaar, or learn to write whole sentences anymore. Yes, now he is holding the bundle of notes and he is thinking it is Anil's money. And he is again thinking probably Anil would have given him 2 or 3 rupees to go to cinema, suppose if he were there in the Anil's room only. And hereafter he need not to cook food for Anil and he need not to run to the bazaar and he need not to learn to write whole sentences anymore. Hereafter he can't learn the sentences. About all these things he is thinking now. I had forgotten about them in the excitement of the theft. Whole sentences I knew could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. It was a simple matter to steal and sometimes just as simple to be caught. But to be a really big man, a clever and respected man was something else. I should go back to Anil, I told myself, if only to learn to read and write. See that. I had forgotten about them in the excitement of the theft. Actually, in the excitement of stealing, he forgotten about his future. And whole sentences, he is thinking about his learning. Already he started to write some words. Thereafter he was about to learn whole sentences. But now he can't learn those things because he is away from Anil now. I knew could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. Now he is thinking, if I were able to learn, I would become what? A great person in my life. I knew could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. Now I have few hundred rupees with me. And if I am able to learn whole sentences, if I am able to learn, read and write properly, then those things would become what? More than these few hundred rupees. He's thinking about that. It was a simple matter to steal and sometimes just as simple to be caught. Stealing was simple matter for him and being caught by the police or some people was also, it was very simple for him. But to be a really big man, a clever and respected man was something else. But becoming a clever man, a big man and respected man was something else. It was difficult one, it was not simple one. I should go back to Anil and he can become like that big man or clever man. By what? By learning, reading and writing. I should go back to Anil, I told myself, if only to learn to read and write. Now, there is in his mind, there is a thought. What is that? Now, I have to go back to Anil. Like this, Hari Singh is thinking. For what purpose he wanted to go back to Anil? Because he wanted to learn, read and write. So, Anil is very much interested to read and write. He wanted to learn how to read and write. For what purpose he was interested that much, we don't know. Probably could have used that knowledge for some bad intention also, we don't know that. But at that moment, he wanted to learn, read and write. For that reason only, again he wanted to go back to Anil. I hurried back to the room, feeling very nervous. For it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. I opened the door quietly, then stood in the doorway. In clouded moonlight, Anil was still sleeping. I crept to the head of the bed and my hand came up with the notes. Yes, after that he hurried back, means he went quickly to the Anil's room, and feeling very nervous at that moment, he was feeling very nervous, he was feeling uneasy. For it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. Yes, for him stealing was very easy, but returning the stealing things without the notice of that person was very difficult for him. Undetected means not found or undiscovered. Returning that thing without the notice of that person was very difficult task for him. Then he opened the door and he stood in the doorway, and at that time the doorway, in the clouded moonlight, already the sky, it was clouded, there was clouded moonlight, and he was still asleep, he was still sleeping, and he moved towards the bed and his hand came up with the bundle of notes. I felt his breath on my hands when he came very near to the bed of Anil. He felt the breathing of Anil on his hands, that inhaling and exhaling of the air. He felt that one. I remained still for a minute. For a minute, he remained still. Then his hand found the edge of the mattress and he slipped under it with the notes. He kept money under the bed. I awoke late next morning to find that Anil had already made the tea. He stretched out in his hand towards me. There was a 50 rupees note between his fingers. My heart sank. I thought I had been discovered. Yes, next day morning, he woke up late. Oh, Hari Singh, he woke up late. Before him, Anil had already woken up and he made tea. And when Hari Singh woke up, Anil, he stretched his hand towards him, Hari Singh. And there was a 50 rupees note between his fingers. When Anil stretched his hands towards Hari Singh, there was a 50 rupees note between his fingers. My heart sank. I thought I had been discovered. For a moment, Hari Singh's heart sank. He became what? Deeply emotional. Okay, he was shocked for a moment and he felt probably he had been discovered. Means Anil might have come to know about his theft. I made some money yesterday, he explained. Now you will be paid regularly. Then Anil, he said, I made some money yesterday. I got some money yesterday and hereafter I will pay you regularly. Means he would pay him regularly. Every month he would pay certain amount as a salary for Hari Singh. Like that Anil said to him. My spirit rose. But when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain. At that moment, He became very happy. My spirit rose means again he got his spirit, means he got his energy. Earlier he thought he had been discovered, that's why he was very sad, but now again he became very happy. But when I took the money note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain. When he took that note, he found that the note was still wet because of the night's rain. Today we will start writing sentences, he said. And Anil said to Hari Singh that day they would start writing sentences. Means Anil, he would teach Hari Singh how to write sentences. He knew, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. And Hari Singh is thinking that probably Anil knew about all those events which were occurred the previous night. But while he was talking, he was not showing such kind of any expressions, either in his lips or in his eyes. He was talking quite naturally. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way. And he gave a smile, his appealing smile, attractive smile. Hari Singh gave attractive smile towards Anil. And the smile came by itself without any effort. Earlier, while he was giving smile, it was artificial smile. But this time, the smile came very naturally. He gave such a natural smile to Anil, to Hari Singh. With this story ended. Let us stop here. We shall move for the another topic in the next session.